subscribe our channel Knowledge Distributor for latest technology and smartphone videos.
10R. Many people have been commenting asking me this question ever since the 10R has arrived to the channel. Should I just go with last year's model, iPhone 10, as the prices are now down on at least the used marketplace as well as other places? There's some leftover stock. You just can't buy the iPhone 10 at Apple.com or at the Apple stores anymore. But you can see these are pretty similar. So let's squash this question and find out which one is the better value. Okay, so when it comes to their price, to me, they're basically a tie right now because the iPhone 10, you're going to find in the same price range as the 10R. Now, if you find a 64 gig, you know, a little bit beat up, got some few scratches on it, you might find it $100 or so under the iPhone 10R. But at this current point of the time of filming this video, I've been seeing the iPhone 10 still in the $700 to $800 price range, which is right in line with the iPhone 10R. Now, if you do know where to look, you can find it in the fives and the sixes, and then it becomes a significantly better price than the iPhone 10R. But for the most part, like on eBay, on Swappa, on, you know, Amazon, I've been seeing the iPhone 10 still in the sevens and eights. So I'm calling them, at least in the mainstream stores, basically still in the same price point. So they're basically a tie when it comes to which one you're going to get with the price. Okay, so what should you buy in terms of design and build? And the iPhone 10 is the winner here, at least in the build quality. Stainless steel sides for the iPhone 10 do give it the edge over these aluminum sides on the iPhone 10R. Now, from the backs, they're both glass, so they're pretty much equal there. However, on the front design, you can see that there's a thicker bezel that comes to the bottom of the iPhone 10R. Also on the sides, the iPhone 10 is just more screen in that same body. Well, it's a little bit of a smaller display, but still, there's more bezel, and the notch is even thicker on the iPhone 10R. Now, in terms of the camera design, you might like this minimal single camera look, or you might like this dual camera look. For me, I like the 10Rs. But when it comes to the overall personalization, the iPhone 10R gets points here. But overall premium design and build, I have to give it to the Apple iPhone 10 for this round. Okay, so when it comes to the displays, the iPhone 10 is the winner because it has OLED technology, which is a superior screen to the LCD when it comes to color contrast ratio, better viewing angles. It does seem to be a little bit brighter as well in my experience. So I'm calling this one a victory to the iPhone 10. It also has less bezel than what you're going to find on the iPhone 10R. You can see a thicker bezel here at the bottom, to the right and to the left. But I think this is not going to matter too much to you if you're not a display snob, like you really care a lot about display. And some people actually preferred LCDs and they weren't happy about the move to OLED. So if you're an LCD lover, you're definitely going to love what Apple did here with the iPhone 10R. Now, one big benefit that the iPhone 10 has on the display is 3D touch, something you won't get for the 10R, which is a big benefit if you did use this a lot and you want to use the shortcuts. You don't get that here. You can also pop into things on the internet browser, like quick tabs and stuff like that. And also, when you do go into your control center up here, these toggles are actually slower for the 10R because of the haptic feedback. In addition, on the lock screen, when you're using 3D touch, it does have a quicker press here to get into that camera for the iPhone 10, just slightly, but it's a little bit better than on the 10R. So when it comes to their displays, the iPhone 10R gives you a little bit bigger display but diminished quality. So I think overall the 10 is the better panel here, hands down, over the 10R. But if you want the bigger display and you're not so much obsessed with, you know, having the most, you know, edge to edge screen, the most high tech OLED panel on the market, you're still going to be very happy with the iPhone 10R, but you do get a bigger notch, it seems like, for the 10R. Now, when it comes to software, it's a tie here because they both run iOS 12.1 and they both run it the same. They're both going to get updates for equally, probably just as long, maybe the 10 1 year less, but it's going to be pretty close as they're both Bionic chipsets and they're both very fast chipsets. So there's no differences here at all. I'm calling it a tie in software. It's iOS as you know it. It's a grid of icons with the new gesture system on the 10R. I think if you had an iPhone 8, 8 Plus, 7 Plus, 7, any phone before the 10, and you're now trying to decide to come here, you're gonna have to learn how to use your gestures and all that, but it's pretty natural. You'll get it in a couple days. It's a tie in terms of the software department. Okay, so in terms of performance, I did a speed test on the iPhone 10 and the iPhone 10R. You can go ahead and check it out. Link down below in the description or up here in a card. But both of these phones do have very powerful Bionic chipsets. The A11 was already ahead of basically everything in the industry from competitors. So any Android phone this year with a Snapdragon 845 is still slower than the Apple A11 from last year. So buying the last year phone right now is still at the top level of performance. Now the A12 is the absolute king of performance over here on the Apple iPhone 10R. However, the A11 Bionic is optimized better in some applications and in some ways in iOS. So the A12 still needs a little bit of software tweaks to be the fastest feeling chip on a phone right now in terms of, you know, iOS as a whole. But I do find that video rendering is quicker, gaming is better on the A12. So if you want the absolute top dog performance, get the 10R. It's the winner here between these two. But if you want to see a more in-depth speed test, like I say, go ahead and check out the speed test down below. But I'm giving the win here in performance to the iPhone XR if you're deciding which one to buy. Okay, so which one should you buy in terms of camera? Now, this one gets a little bit tricky because they both have their benefits over each other. And, you know, the ones that are more important, I think, do reside with the XR. But let's talk about them. So the iPhone X has a 2x optical zoom. So when you do hit the camera and you hit the 2x, you're basically going to be able to get lossless zoom. So you can go ahead and zoom in and you should still have the same quality you would get basically on the 1x. Now the aperture is a little bit lower for the single lens, so it's a better aperture on the single primary lens for the iPhone X, but still you'll get much better quality at 2x zoom for the iPhone X. And this has object detection in portrait mode, so you can put objects in your portrait mode and it could still attempt to blur the background. Now it doesn't work that well compared to some of the newer portrait modes you're gonna find on, you know, the Google Pixel 3, for example, but still it works pretty good. So going in the settings here in the camera department for the iPhone X, you're gonna see that we do have the ability to record up to 4K at 60 frames per second, but there's a big differentiator between this phone and the iPhone XR. And that's in this camera setting, you do have smart HDR. And this is the game changer, which makes me give the win to the iPhone XR. What this does is it basically combines multiple exposures and it's just a more intelligent camera to give you a much better shot depending on your lighting. Now with the iPhone X, there's also a little bit more noise in the photos I found, especially when the lights get low. So in low lighting, the iPhone XR is better, but in just regular everyday use in daylight, it's gonna be hard to distinguish the difference, but I still think the XR is the better camera because it's the one that takes the better photos when you just point and shoot. Now that zoom is important. If you do a lot of zoom photography and you do a lot of object detection portrait modes, you might still want the iPhone X. But portrait is really designed for people and that's where it works pretty well for the XR. So if I had to pick one in terms of camera, I think the XR with the better primary lens gives it the win for me, because for me the primary lens is more important than being able to zoom 2x for the iPhone X. So which one should you buy in terms of the battery life? This is an easy win. The iPhone XR has easily been crushing the iPhone X in battery life. In my experience, they both have a 100% health here on both my devices, but this one just goes so much longer, like 2.5 hours better. This reminds me a lot of the Note 9 in battery life versus this one just being like, you know, a regular iPhone that just gets you through most of the day but might die by the end of the night. But the XR can stretch into the next day. It's fantastic. I'm finishing the day at like 79%. I don't even understand how this is that good for the XR, seeing that the battery capacity is under 3000 for the device. So the XR is the one you want if you want the better battery life, hands down. Okay, so when it comes to their audio, they both have speakers at the bottom and up at the top. I have tested these and I can tell you right now that the iPhone XR is slightly louder than the iPhone X, just slightly, like 10 or 20%. So if you're looking for the better external audio, you're gonna want the XR. I also found the Bluetooth connection to be even quicker for the XR for some reason. So if you want the better audio experience, get the XR. You're gonna be happy with that device. You'll also be happy with the iPhone X, as it's not a bad audio experience at all. But I think that there's a slight edge, like a 10 or 15% edge to the iPhone XR. All right, so in terms of phone calls, it's pretty much a tie here for me. I haven't had any drop calls for either of these and I can't even remember how long, and both have never really given me a connectivity issue either when it comes to Wi-Fi performance and LTE performance on these two devices. So I've been having a great experience on both of these and I'm calling it a tie in this regard. I wouldn't pick either based on this aspect. Okay guys, so we've discussed basically every area of the iPhone X and XR, and you could see in the price they tied in design and build, it goes to the X, display quality to the X, software is a tie, performance to the XR, camera to the XR, battery life to the XR, audio to the XR, and the phone calling's a tie. So at my final conclusion on all the areas that matter in buying a smartphone, there was 2 wins for the iPhone X, 3 ties, and 4 wins for the iPhone XR. So 4 wins to 2 wins on the iPhone XR gives it the victory here for the better value phone, and I think the one that I would buy between both of these. Now, if those certain areas like the display quality and the more premium, more XS kind of feeling design matter more to you, then that can be enough to sell you over the XR. But the XR offers a lot of things that make it harder to pick this phone over this phone, and that mainly being the camera, mainly being that A12 Bionic chipset, which is more future-proofed, and having the better battery life, which is a big deal for many people. In addition, you just get a lot more personalization with the color. So that's just a nice added touch for the XR, but not the real seller. The real seller is the battery life, the camera, and the processor. If you guys found this video